Hi there. Nice that you tuned into the course videos again. So far we have taken many steps. We started by listing the actors and making their problem explicit, and later came up with many alternatives. The next step is to help yourself or your client to make a choice between all these different alternatives. In the videos on estimates and uncertainty, we showed that in the end you compare your alternatives on different criteria. The most common form is a table with all alternatives in the first row and all criteria in the first column. In this video, we show you how to construct this table and what different forms there are. Then it is up to you to decide which form is most useful in your situation. Let's go back to the example we used in an earlier video. In the early 1990s, there were serious plans to construct a high-speed rail line between Amsterdam in the Netherlands via Brussels in Belgium to Paris in France. At that time, the government presented three different alternatives for this rail line. The first, a completely new line, the second, using the current track with some small adjustments, and the third, a combination of building a new line and using part of the current tracks. Even though the second alternative was declared the cheapest and easiest, the track was considered too slow to be competitive with cars and planes. The Parliament preferred alternative one, an entirely new line, as it would meet environmental and transportation aspects better than the other alternatives. However, many actors had different alternatives as their preferred solution, for many different reasons. So how can we, as analysts or consultants, help these people to make a clear choice among the different alternatives? What you want to do is to make a clear overview of the analysis so far that enables to compare the alternatives and see how they score on the different criteria. Basically, this technique is multi-criteria analysis. It does not tell us whether an alternative is good or bad. However, it does tell something about how an alternative scores on the different criteria. So it makes a comparison of different alternatives possible. In this course, we provide two techniques to perform a multi-criteria analysis: the scorecard technique and the simple multi-attribute rating technique, or SMART in short. The second is based upon the first, so let's start with the scorecard. The first thing to do is to choose for what context scenario you will make a scorecard. Alternatives will score differently in different potential futures. As consultant or manager, you do not only want to compare the alternatives on criteria, but you also want to know what alternatives are robust, that is, what alternatives perform relatively well in many different potential futures. Then, go back to your criteria analysis and take the list of criteria you have chosen there to use in your scorecard. Just give it an extra check and make sure these are all clear, relevant, and have well-defined units. The criteria you put in this scorecard should be the same criteria you used in your causal diagram and in your problem diagram. Put all the alternatives that you want to compare in the first row. Here you put your complete list. In principle, they are the same alternatives you have identified and used in your causal diagram and your problem diagram. However, there, for practical reasons, you might have made summaries and listed not all, but a set of alternatives. Otherwise, problem diagrams are far less useful for communication as they contain too much information. Here, you list all alternatives, whether there are 4 or 400. Now, by taking values from the literature, by doing experiments, consulting experts, or making estimates, determine the scores and fill in these scores in the table. Do this for all criteria and your initial table is finished. The SMART builds upon the scorecard and is a more extensive technique for comparing alternatives. It focuses on what criteria are more important for a certain actor and have a higher priority. This means that SMARTs are designed specifically for one actor, as everybody will have different objectives and thus ideas about what is important and what is not. That means that the first step here is not only to choose for which scenario you will make the SMART, but also for which actor. The priority for criteria that a certain actor has is indicated by a weight per criterion. So you add another column for the weight factors in your table. Make sure to motivate why a weight is given. In essence, you're trying to make explicit what an actor has implicitly in his or her head about his or her objectives and preferences. Then, normalize the scores. This can be done in many different ways. We present you here a normalization of scores into values between 0 and 1, 0 being the worst and 1 being the best. There are three steps. The first is to determine for every criterion what the highest and lowest value is for all alternatives. So seek the highest and the lowest value in each row. Then subtract the lowest value from the highest value. This gives you the scoring range for every criterion. So, again, you have a scoring range for every row. Then, second, use the absolute difference between the to-be-normalized value and the lowest value for that criterion. So you take the score in the cell you want to normalize, and you take the lowest score from that whole row. Calculate the absolute difference between them. The third step is to divide this number by the range you found in step one. Now you have normalized your scores. They all should have a value between 1 and 0. 0 being the worst and 1 being the best. Add another row to the table for the weighted sum of the normalized values for each alternative. You get these by multiplying each value with the weight and add the scores.
Hello, my name is Paulien Herder and I'm a professor in engineering systems design at the Delft University of Technology. My area is the design and innovation of energy systems. Systems integration, smart grids, and you can also think about how to transition our society into a renewable energy system. And I do this at a large group here in Delft with about 50 researchers. And I'm also chair of the Delft Energy Initiative, where we bundle about 700 different researchers in energy. And the Delft Energy Initiative has the intention to move all of the energy research in Delft forward in a concerted effort. In my research, I use scorecards quite a lot. For example, we are studying the way renewable energy can be integrated into the electricity grid. When we want to do that, we need a couple of alternatives to make sure that we can store and use the energy at a required time. So we can use large-scale storage, we could use smaller-scale storage, for example, in cars, or we can think about the option of demand-side management. Now, in order to study these alternatives within my research team, we use scorecards. And these scorecards help us in various ways. If we use them next to our problem diagrams, this combination is excellent for communication purposes within our team, but also with our outside stakeholders. The scorecards also help us to understand exactly what criteria are important to study and understand the viability of these alternatives. And what also helps us in using these scorecards is when we understand what criteria are relevant, that we start to think about how we can measure these criteria and what kind of modeling and analysis we still need to do to fill out these scorecards. So this combination of ease of communication, helping us or even maybe forcing us to understand what kind of criteria are there and how we can measure and model them, helps us a lot in getting a fast and good grip on the entire quite complex problem. So the use of problem diagrams in combination with scorecards helped us to evaluate the alternatives and to compare them. And it forced us to make the criteria and their measurement and modeling very explicit.
Hello everyone, nice to see you back. Here's again an example you can easily remember. For this, we go back to our student we introduced you a few weeks ago in the video on problem statements. This student wants to combine studying with many extracurricular activities and has trouble finding the right balance. After receiving a negative advice of the study counselor, meaning she has to leave the curriculum and try her luck somewhere else, our student decided to take a proactive approach to quickly decide which option would be the best to keep studying in Delft while maintaining as much as possible extra fun activity next to her studies. She has spent the last week considering all possible things to do to improve the current situation. After doing all analysis of the problem situation and brainstorming for different alternatives, it was time to consider the impact of the possible alternatives, both on our study results as on our private life. When she started filling in the scorecard, it became immediately clear that doing nothing was no option, because then she would have to quit studying because of the negative study advice. By looking at the consequences of several alternatives, like dropping one of her hobbies or sports, skipping some of the courses, taking a less active role in our committee, sleeping less, and many others, the student was able to come to a conclusion about the set of actions to improve the study results without harming her private life too much.
Hey, nice you're watching again. Let me help you by applying scorecards and smarts to your own case. If you use the book in addition to the videos, please read chapter 5. After that, create a scorecard for every scenario you have. Score the different alternatives on your well-balanced set of criteria from your goal trees. Using these scorecards as a basis, now make smarts. You make one for every actor you've identified in your problem situation, and for every scenario. The number of smarts can be quite high. Most of the time, it's only interesting to make them if you use a computer. Then you can easily compare all these smarts to pick out the most robust solution. Usually, we don't see a lot of mistakes when people create scorecards. However, we do see them when people transform their scorecards into smarts. The first is to keep in mind which direction of your criterion is seen as positive by the actor. This could very well be different for different actors. When a certain alternative has higher costs, this is obviously a bad score for the one who has to pay, but not necessarily for the one who sells. In smarts, you don't see the raw scores anymore, only a score between 0 and 1. Thus, it is very important that you do the normalization well. It's a good habit to show how you carried out the normalization, so everybody can see what you did. The second is about weight factors. Remember that the weight factors have a huge impact on the rank order of alternatives. Therefore, you should do thorough research. Find out what the actor really finds more or less important than other criteria, how much and why. High weight factors of a factor 3 or higher cause a criterion to easily outrule all the other criteria completely, so be modest. It can also be quite tempting to tweak the weight factors to get the desired outcome for your client. Often, you will feel pressure from your client to actually do that. But try to work as analytical as possible. However, playing with the weight factors can be quite interesting to show the client how sensitive the scores are. The analytical ranking order of an alternative can suddenly be completely different after a very small change in the weight factors. This information can be even more interesting than the specific scores of the alternatives, as it says something about the usefulness of the method. Finally, don't forget that the highest ranked alternative of the SMART table is not necessarily the best solution for the problem. SMART was just a tool to make the views of actors on what is important explicit. Use scorecards and SMARTs as a group tool. Discuss and come to a decision on what to do together. That is, in the end, the objective of doing all these analyses. To get agreement on what to do, to choose and to implement, so your complex problem gets solved.